Who doesn't love a nice, relaxing day at the beach? But have you ever wondered where does the sand color come from? And why are there so many different sand colors? In today's video, we'll explore beautifully colored sand beaches around the world and learn what gives sand its color. Hello, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, my name is Maria, and I'm a scientist and a sci-fi fantasy writer, sharing with you the wonders of our world. And today's wonder is colored sand beaches around the world. A few years ago, I went for a holiday in the island of Bermuda in the Atlantic Ocean. There, I spent some time on this beautiful pink sand beach in the Horseshoe Bay. That pink sand beach, plus the most amazing turquoise water I've ever seen, inspired a location in my first novel, A Pink Sand Beach on an Alien Planet. Seeing that pink sand beach in Bermuda got me curious as to why was the sand pink. And when researching the color of the sand, I came across a large variety of colored sand beaches around the world. They vary from white sand beaches all the way to black sand beaches. So let's explore them together and see what gives sand its color. We'll go from light color sand to dark color sand, and in the end, I have a bonus or two about multicolored sand beaches. But before we go into the colors, let's see what is sand. Sand is a granular material composed of very small particles whose dimensions can range anywhere between 0.0625 millimeters and 2 millimeters. Its composition varies depending on the location and the composition of the rock sources, as we will see when we explore the different colored sand beaches. But the most common component of sand is quartz. Quartz is a silica mineral. It is silicon dioxide. Sand is produced through a weathering process of rocks and minerals. Some of these natural weathering processes include rain, wind, and ocean currents, as well as freezing-thawing cycles. Since the weathering processes do not affect quartz, this mineral remains in its small granular form, and it is transported to the shore, forming the sand we see at the beach. And the reason for the usual overall yellowish color of the sand is the presence of impurities in the quartz crystal, or a mixture of quartz with other particles. However, not all beaches are made up of sand rich in quartz. We will see what are the main components are present in the sand when we go through the different sand colors. So let's start exploring the colored sand beaches around the world, going from light colored sands to dark colored sands. And we will start with the white sand beaches. As I mentioned earlier, sand is made up of quartz. But usually, quartz also contains impurities or is mixed with other particles, giving sand its yellowish color. However, when the quartz grains are pure and not mixed with any other particles, we get a white-colored sand. And that's the case of the Hymes Beach in New South Wales, Australia. Its finely ground pure quartz crystals is what makes the sand of this beach so white that it got into the Guinness Book of Records as the whitest sand beach. Other white sand beaches include the Matura Beach in Bora Bora, French Polynesia, Boulders Beach in Cape Town, South Africa, and Tulum Beach in Mexico. Let's move on to the pink sand beaches. The pink color of the sand comes from tiny organisms called foraminifera. They are single-cell organisms which build shells around themselves from the minerals they find in the water. Usually, these shells are made of calcium carbonate, with the shell color ranging from pink to red. When the foraminifera organisms die, the remains of their shells are washed to shore. By mixing these pink to red foraminifera shell remains with the quartz particles, we get the beautiful pink sand that we can admire in the Horseshoe Bay Beach in Bermuda, or the Pink Sand Beach on Harbour Island in the Bahamas, Elafonisi on the island of Crete in Greece, Tangsi Beach on Lombok Island in Indonesia, and many other places around the world. Let me know in the comments which is the most beautiful beach you've ever seen, either one that you've been to or one that you've seen in a picture and would love to visit one day. Next, we have the orange sand beaches. When the sand contains minerals that are rich in iron, the sand gets an orange color. In the calcium carbonate-based sands, the calcium carbonate comes from the weathering of rocks made of limestone. If there are traces of iron present in the limestone, then those iron impurities mixed with the calcium carbonate, crushed cells, and volcanic deposits will produce an orange-colored sand. We find orange sand beaches in the Ramla Bay in Gozo, Malta, in Porto Covo in Portugal, and Portoferro in Sardinia. Let's move on to the red sand beaches. Where does the red color of the sand come from? It's rust!
Wait, what? Sand rust? Let's find out the answer!
There are many volcanic beaches around the world created by the past and present eruptions of volcanoes. When the lava from the volcanic eruption cools down, it solidifies, forming the volcanic rock. If this happens above the surface of the ocean, the iron from the lava rock reacts with the oxygen from the air, forming iron oxide, or what we commonly refer to as rust. We've seen previously that sand forms through the different weathering processes of rocks. Through the weathering of these iron oxide-rich volcanic rocks, the rock is ground into the red sand particles that give the red sand its color. Red sand beaches are found in volcanic regions such as the Kaihalulu Beach in Maui, Hawaii, Rabida Island in Galapagos, Ecuador, and Cavendish Beach on Prince Edward Island in Canada. Next comes a very unusual colored sand beach, the purple sand beach. We now know that sand comes from the weathering of rocks. When it comes to the purple sand beaches, the quartz grains are mixed with particles coming from the erosion of rocks from the nearby hills that contain the manganese garnet mineral. The rain washes down these manganese garnet particles to the shore, mixing them with the quartz grains on the beach. This creates patches of purple-looking sand where the two types of sand particles mix. The heavier the rain, the more abundant the purple areas of sand. This is what we see at the Pfeiffer Beach in California. But we also find purple beaches in other areas where the color purple comes from the mixing of a variety of grains of different colors. These include grains of pink almandine-pyrope garnet, white quartz, and a mix of black minerals including augite, ilmenite, and hematite, and green epidote. I will not get into details about all these different minerals, but if you want to learn more about them, I'll add links with information on each mineral in the video description. All these particles together create the purple sand at the Plum Island Beach in the state of Massachusetts in the US.
We are now halfway through the list. Before we move on, if you find value in this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so we can explore together in future videos interesting places on Earth. Let's move on now to darker sand colors.
Next, we have the green sand beaches. We saw earlier that the red sand beaches get their red color from the volcanic rocks formed from the cooling of lava from volcanic eruptions. When the lava is rich in a mineral called olivine, upon cooling of the lava, the olivine crystals are formed. As they separate from the lava and accumulate on the beach, these particles are the ones responsible for the rare green-colored sand beaches. Examples of green-colored sand beaches include the Papakolea Beach on the Big Island in Hawaii and the Kourou Beach in French Guiana. Next up are the brown sand beaches. Now let's talk about a brown, chocolate-colored beach, the Rockaway Beach in Pacifica, California. While the chocolate color might tempt you to take a bite of this peculiar-looking sand, I wouldn't recommend it unless you really love the taste of limestone and volcanic greenstone, because that's what this sand is made of. The combination of particles from an impure limestone of bluish-gray color with those from dark greenish volcanic greenstone is what creates this chocolatey sand beach. I wouldn't eat it, but I would still love to see it. Now, let's see the gray sand beaches. Gray sand beaches could have their origin in either a combination of shale with graywacke sandstone, or in a combination of basalt granules from lava rocks with fragmented shells, corals, and other marine creatures. Gray sand beaches can be found in Shelter Cove in Humboldt County, California, various beaches on the Santorini Island in Greece, and beaches from other volcanic regions. And now, the darkest of them all, the black sand beaches. Just as some of the gray sand beaches are based on basalt, so are the black ones. The black sand beaches are made of basalt granules coming from the weathering of the basaltic rocks formed through the rapid cooling of the lava when it reaches the ocean water. Some famous black sand beaches include the black sand beach in Vik, Iceland, the Pumalu Beach in Hawaii, the Muriwai Black Sand Beach in New Zealand, and Playa Negra in Puerto Viejo, Costa Rica.
I've only seen the Black Sand Beach in Iceland, and it was a really impressive view. Maybe it's worth including a Black Sand Beach in one of my novels as well, because it's such an interesting place. And I definitely recommend for you to visit a Black Sand Beach if you can. Now that we finished going through all these different sand colors, it's time for the bonus I mentioned in the beginning, the multicolored sand beach. But I will actually give you two bonuses here, both of them multicolored beaches, but one of them is natural made and the other one is man-made.
Let's start with the natural multicolored beach. A famous example of a multicolored sand beach is a beach in Queensland, Australia. It is called Rainbow Beach, and for a good reason. It is a beach where many different sand colors blend to create a one-of-a-kind landscape. While not all the colors of a rainbow are present, the combination of different hues of red, orange, and yellow do still provide a merging of colors similar to what we see in a rainbow. Where do these multicolored sands come from? They come from the nearby huge sand cliffs made from many layers of sand deposits over long periods of time. And the ingredient responsible for these sand colors is the iron oxide from the sand. The action of rain and wind on these enormous sand cliffs causes the sand of different colors to advance on the beach and intermingle, giving rise to the rainbow sands. And finally, the man-made colored beaches, the glass beaches. When I say man-made, I don't mean intentionally made by people, but humans were indirectly the creators because these beaches are made of glass. They are present at trash dumping sites where glass was dumped over the years on the shore. That was before waste disposal and recycling systems were put into practice. In these areas, after decades of perfect conditions like the action of waves and currents, the pieces of broken glass were transformed into small, colorful, pebble-like fragments that are now the basis of these glass beaches. Some examples of glass beaches include the glass beach in Kauai in Hawaii and the glass beach near Fort Bragg, California.
I hope you enjoyed going with me on this virtual expedition around our world's colored beaches. If you want to learn more about the different color sand beaches, I've added some resources for you in the video description. Also, if you're curious to learn about the pink sand beach on the alien planet in my novel, I have a link in the video description below where you can subscribe to my newsletter and I will let you know when my book comes out. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye!